Saturday kicks off the Affordable Care Act's second annual enrollment period. You probably remember when those of us looking to buy insurance last year had issues with healthcare.gov.
But other than fixing glitches in the website, what else has changed about this year's enrollment? Well, we talked to a local expert to find out what you need to know.
Honestly, I really don't know a whole lot.
Bethany Crutcher isn't alone when it comes to knowing the ins and outs of the Affordable Care Act.
I've just heard that, you know, if you don't have insurance, then you want to get it because it's going to be this huge tax.
Starting January of 2014, everyone had to have some kind of health care coverage.
The penalties for not having insurance are enforced through the tax system, and in 2014 they were lower than they're going to be for 2015.
If you didn't have coverage this year, $95 or 1% of your yearly income, whichever is higher, will be tacked on to taxes you pay this spring. But in 2015, that fine goes up to $325 or 2% of your income.
The interest is in increasing people's incentives to enroll as time goes on.
If you're happy with your current coverage, Dr. Laura Daig with the Bush School of Government and Public Service says it's a good idea to double check that your plan is best for 2015's needs.
Even if you don't want to buy a new plan, you probably want to go in and update your information.
But if you're in the market for a new plan, Dr. Daig says shop around.
What you really need to know in order to figure out what plan to buy is what your healthcare expenses are going to be for the next year, and it's hard to predict.
And if you are in the market for a healthcare plan but need some help picking out the right one, the group Enroll Brazos Valley can help. We have enrollment assistance events and their contact information under this story on our website at kagstv.com.